do some more work. So we had to pick one. So that was an absolutely impossible job. But on the other hand, we felt it was actually a really, really easy job. If you really thought about it, but all the 20 are really, really good, we could throw a dart, pick one, and all of you would think, well, what a great choice. So it's actually really a very, very easy job. We just could not go wrong, because all the 20 were just absolutely amazing. So when we came in, we thought this would be a 10-minute job, and we said, you know, we'll quickly go out and go have some fun. But it turned out to be a 3-hour job. Okay, we went out there, and you were having fun out here. Some of us worked hard. So it was a long process, and honestly, at any point in the day, all of the 20 were in the mix, and at various stages, it was just absolutely crazy. So I thought I'd take a couple of seconds telling you what we looked for. And fundamentally, we looked for just goodness in many categories. We looked for people women that were leaders in their field, that had put in sustained effort into something big and grew it from something small and made it big. So sustained effort was good. Someone was a role model. Someone was an inspiration to others. Creative was a big word. Inspiration was another big one, who would inspire us and inspire others who would follow in their footsteps. Social entrepreneurism was also very big. So fundamentally, people who were just very, 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 very darn good. So as you can imagine, of all the 20, they were all very, 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 very darn good. And the person we picked has all of these characteristics. And the person we picked, it's a woman. So that gives you a clue. So she's a leader in the media. Okay, she's an educator. She's involved in dance. She's given a lot to her community, and has made a huge impact on our entire community. Well, let's get more specific. She started something from nothing. Like, it took something that was just a gleam in her eye and built it into something big. Okay, made it viral. So if she were at Harvard, like Mark Zuckerberg, she would have gone to California. Okay, and had donated to an 800 million person enterprise. But she wasn't Mark Zuckerberg. She wasn't at Harvard. Okay, she went, was a different school. They had different aspirations than 800 million people and multi-billion dollars. So she was focused more on the community, focused more on giving, focused more on helping. So with that, I'm really pleased to announce The New England News, 2012, the Woman of the Year, Dole Roll. Let's try it again. Dole Roll. Anthony Saigal.
take a picture. Do we have a
I have to say one thing. Last year when I won, and I didn't expect it, my husband wasn't here, and Ranjini has won today, and Anil is not here. So maybe we will be starting a new tradition, you know? If you want to win, then come along and bring your husbands back next year.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. It's such an honor to be here from many, many angles, I think. But the first one is I would like to sincerely thank India New England for choosing me for this position, because we are kind of in the same space, and to get honored by a peer, a leading peer like you, means a lot to me. So thank you so much, India New England. Okay, Guruji, thank you so much. Subhu sir, I call him Subhu sir, I never call him Mr. Kotia. He has supported so many of our events, and that I am here at an event that he has supported. He's a great supporter of the underprivileged, of women. We are not underprivileged, but still, he supports us a lot. Thank you, Subhu sir. Much appreciated. Really, thank you. My first thanks goes to all my nominators, and to each one of you who took the time out of your very busy schedules to write a few good words about me. I've been feeling a winner since I learned that I was nominated, even before anything else, because nothing is more touching to the soul than to have a friend write a few good words about you, especially people who know you. So much, much honor about that. And again, the other thing that I wanted to mention, when I didn't know who the list of judges were, and to see people that I absolutely admire, and Dr. Ananda Gabba was somebody I just recently interviewed. His work on edX is just phenomenal. And of course, my dear darling Manjushree, and the others, you know, Dr. Amar Gupta, I did not know that these were the great judges, and to be selected by this cohort means a lot to me. I think I got that award for two things. One is education, and the other is community service. You know, I don't know that it's even deserving to get an award for community service, because as many of you people know, you know, it is just a great opportunity that we got to serve. It's the Lord who takes care of everybody, but sometimes He allows people, and sometimes He has allowed this little one to serve as well. So I really, really thank this opportunity. You know, I think of the great saying that the great Yajnavalkya said, you know, that everything you do is for your own happiness, you know. Nahi devanam kamaya devaha priya bhavantu, atmanastu kamaya devaha priya bhavantu. Even the gods, you love them because it's for your own good. And I really think it is, you know, something that has been so special to me. And that I have this, the other thing I wanted to say is, just like this great peer honored me, this is the greatness of the Quavon Reservoir Water, that everybody here collaborates in the New England area. We don't compete. My fellow dancers collaborate. My fellow Lokwani team members collaborate. We do great things because we come together. And to get a peer like this, instead of competing, collaborating with us, I hope we come together to do great things together. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And and as I was coming, I heard this great quote from Khalil Gibran, and I thought that was a very good one. It said that people may think I am nuts, because I do not sell my time for money. But I think the world is nuts because they think they can value my time in gold. And I think Khalil Gibran, near here to him, you know, great man. But I do think that the work that we do that cannot be valued in gold is the one that satisfies the heart the most. And for women, I think especially, it is what gives us a rise spiritually and takes us to the next level. So thank you all, thank the Lord for giving me an opportunity to do many things and to be here. And you can hold me accountable next year and ask me, what did I do with my life? So thank you so much. And really, Manju, it's, I cannot imagine walking in your beautiful footsteps. Really, really. And thank you all. And I will let my husband and children, by the way, I do have to give a moment of thanks to my entire family. My father, who has been my inspiration all through my life. My mother, the funny one, who keeps me grounded all her life. My wonderful children, who still seem to love me and call me. And my dear sister, who happens to be in town today, can you please? My family member. And finally, my poor, poor husband, who, you know, this poor Punjabi, when he married this dancing Tali, and he had no idea what he was getting into. Really, you know, Bharat Natyam marathon, that's what goes on in my house. And, you know, Agni ko sakshi maan ke mujhe shaadi kiye the, they didn't know. I'd be always jumping into Agni, and he has to pick me up and support me. So, to me, my great God Krishna, my Parthasarathi, who drives me around, thank you, thank you, thank you, and really, honor to be here. Thank you. I'm told this is a good platform to make a pitch, so I am going to pitch for one thing. July 15th, please come and see us dance and support the Visually Challenged at Vision Aid. So please go to visionaid.org and please run in money. Yes, they are great people, and I'm going to be an evil woman, Shura Batman, who is going to become a beautiful peacock. First time in my life. So please come and see me. Thank you.
Once again, thanks to everyone and all the fine